Welcome back to Workout Wednesday. I'm here at the top of beautiful Gates Pass in Tucson, Arizona. Today's video is going to be a little bit different. I'm going to tell you about myself and how I reached the peak of my fitness. Right now, I'm the fittest I've ever been, and I just want to tell you about my journey, how I got here, a little bit about myself. This is huge. I'm currently doing the biggest giveaway I've ever done. Check the description. I'm giving away like 9 different items: Durace crank, Allen keys, ticker heart rate strap, all this cool stuff that every cyclist would love. Check the description, click the link, easy to enter. You can enter all the giveaways. But that's not the big news. The big news is I have a company shipping me a bike for free. I'm gonna test the bike, I'm gonna show it to you, and then that is gonna become the biggest giveaway I've ever done. The people that have been following me from the beginning know it's been a dream of mine to give away a bike, so that's coming soon. Stay tuned, love you guys. Let's go down. Usually these videos, I show you a workout, and I'll do that. It'll be in the description of this video. But first, let me preface, what is the fittest I've ever been? Like, what is that exactly? So right now, I could probably do 420, 430 watts for 20 minutes, 400 watt FTP. My coach has it in there at about 412. That's what he has my FTP in at right now. So that's what I do on my workouts around. I did 450 for 12 minutes. I've done stuff like that. A lot of people don't realize there's a big difference between having a big engine, which I have, but being good at cycling, like knowing when to attack, when to sit in, when to save energy, when to use your energy, all that kind of stuff. And I'm not really good at that stuff because I'm like a late athlete. I started in my 30s, my early 30s. I started about 2014 is when I started taking cycling on serious. The lowest I've seen is 158 pounds. The highest I've seen is about 169. I fluctuate in around there. I'm probably on the lower end right now. Sorry, there's a bee here. And I really don't like weighing myself too often. I find it messes with my head. I just really focus on eating clean and not taking the diet too crazy. Otherwise, I can get a little nutty. I feel like I sideline myself if I start eating too little. In terms of some of my accomplishments, I'm not saying this to brag, but just to kind of give you context of the video, I came 5th at provincials, which is like state championships back in 2019. I'm way fitter now, but we haven't raced in 2 years. I'll probably start racing next year. All the segments in Ontario, I can contend, either get the KOM or definitely be on the leaderboard. Here in the shootout, I'm up with the front guys, rotating, attacking, solo breakaway, breakaways, stuff like that. So anyways, just to give you context, like where I am, I don't think I could get any fitter, maybe a couple percent. But this is, you know, I turn 40 next year. This is probably nearing the end of the road for myself. But I wanted to like tell you guys like my mindset and like kind of what got me here to see if it could help any of you. So basically I started cycling in 2014. The reason I started is when my marriage was on the rocks and my wife and I wanted to do something together. So we picked running, and then we got a running coach. Our running coach was a triathlete. She said, you should get a bike. You should learn how to swim and do a triathlon. That's what we did. I started doing that, but I fell in love with cycling. Cycling, I absolutely love. I love the bikes. I love the gear. I love the guys. I love the races. I love everything about cycling. So I fell in love with it and I got a coach. I've always had a coach and I really think that's a big part of my success. I know there's going to be a comment that says, oh, what if you can't afford a coach? Well, I'm sorry if you can't afford a coach. I could, and I would highly recommend it to see if you could find it in the budget, but it's really helped me. I've always had a coach, but something that I found really interesting along the way of my fitness, from 2014 to 2018, I was part-time. I was probably riding 10 to 12 hours a week because I was working my butt off. I was building my business. And what happened was my dad filed for bankruptcy when I was about 24, and I watched him come tow his cars, and that was a big wake-up call for me. So I started a property management business and I just went crazy. I worked. And my dad kind of worked for the company part-time. less than part-time, giving him a lot of money because the company became very successful. And my brother and I, who was working for the company at the time, we had a big blowout with my father. I came back from vacation and he took my car. It was a brand new Mercedes, $100,000 Mercedes. He took it out of the driveway. I call him like, hey, out of my garage. I'm like, hey dad, where's my car? He's like, oh, I got it. And I'm like, okay, cool. Can I get it back from you? He's like, nah, I think it's better I have the car. So this is just one of many things. I let him keep it. And this is just one of many things where he started calling me every day and like, oh, your mother's a fucking bitch, and like running my mother down. And it was a very, very toxic relationship. He started renovating his house on the company visa. So anyways, my brother and I sat him down. We had a bit of an intervention with him and said, look, you know, we're going to put you on a salary. This is all you can have. You're only working part-time. I got to get my car back. You got to go to marriage counseling with mom because you're just ruining her life. And he basically didn't negotiate on anything, pointed at me, you're not my son, leave my house. And after that, I was living in this big mansion of a house that I sold, and I downsized into a house about a third of the size. And I took the money, I bought 3 investment properties. At this time, I had a lot of pain. Like, I was really suffering, because up until that point I respected my father and I thought he was a great guy. So I was really struggling and I needed to take a step away from the business. So what I did is I sold half of the company, 49% of the company, to my brother, and said I will just manage it from a distance. We'll talk every day, we'll oversee everything, but you're gonna run the day-to-day. That's what we did about 4 years ago. And at that point I retired and started cycling for full time. Since then, 5 years later, since my brother taking over, he doubled the size of the business from when he started running it. So things are going really well for us in terms of financial. That's when I started cycling full time, is about 4 years ago. I said, I'm gonna do 20 hours a week, I'm gonna hire a top coach, and I'm gonna go nuts. And from the first year of doing that, I lost about 20 pounds, and that jumped my fitness up huge. But looking back, basically what happened, and the whole thing with the company, just put me in a bad place. I was in a lot of pain for a couple years, just realizing that, you know, does my father love me? He's not the guy he said he was gonna be, and just all this stuff. And my brother still won't talk to him. And so cycling was an outlet for me. And I just put everything I had into it. So away I went. So what I found interesting though over the years is I found the fitter I got, the more I had to focus on stuff to keep the fitness. So at the beginning, the fitness comes really easy. You don't even need a coach. You could probably just join a club ride with the group 3 times a week, ride with the club 3 times a week, and you're gonna get fit. But after the years went on, it just became harder and harder to get fitness. And so recently, the coach I've just hired this year, Tom Danielson from Cinch Cycling, he's hands down, I've had 4 different coaches, he's hands down the best coach. He's got me to the best fitness that I've ever had, and with way less stress, riding a little bit less, but more intensity, and the workouts are easier to do. It's been absolutely awesome. I can't say enough about the guy. I'll put his website in the description if you're interested. That's what I found. As I got fitter, I had to tweak the diet. I had to be more focused on the diet, more focused on my weight, more focused on the coaching. Do I have the best coach? And then it was, the gains become a lot slower as you go on. That's why I come to Tucson, because the caliber of riders here, and I'm gonna get some video on this week's shootout. There's Quinn Simmons from Trek Segafredo, Tyler Stites, there's Keegan Swenson, there's Sam Long, Ben Hoffman, there's all these guys that are like top of the food chain, and to get out there and pull turns with them, get in a breakaway with them, and like talk to them and learn from them is so amazing. And I heard this interesting thing, you're only gonna be as good as your best competition. And I heard someone talking about that. And it's true, if you stay in your local group ride, you're only gonna get as good as the best guy there. And so that's definitely a big reason why I come here. The number one thing that helped me was the time. once I didn't have to work and I could focus all my energy on cycling, that's the thing that absolutely helped me the most. Just the mental energy. I gotta squeeze this ride in because I gotta get to work. Then I gotta have family time. My wife's gonna be pissed off. I didn't have to worry about any of that stuff. All I had to do was ride and then go home with the family, make a couple business calls, and that's it. So just the mental energy alone is huge. But then it's also the time. Like, I get to ride at the best hours of the day. I get to have extra time for strength workout, stretching, all that stuff. So that was number one. Like, there's no doubt in my mind, if you have a full-time job, it is way harder. I don't even know if it would have been possible for me to get the fitness that I'm at now if I kept my full-time job. I'm almost certain of that. Number two is consistency, is just dig in every day, day in, day out. And like, my wife told me to mention this, and this may sound funny, but like, I would say more than 50% of the rides when I start them, I would say 75% of the rides when I start them, I don't want to do it. But then I know I'll get it going, I'll get out there, I'll love it, and then by the time I come home, I'll feel like $1 million. So like, if you're ever feeling like you don't want to do a ride, don't worry. Most guys out there training hard feel like that a lot. So the big part is just pushing through it. I heard this thing from a famous athlete a long time ago. He said, do you think a champion ever stops himself from working out? So now I'm not going to do this today. No, they go, they do it. They don't even think about it. They go, they do the workouts, whether they want to or not. So I just took that in, and it's easy. There's something about it for me where the goal has never been a race for me. The goal has always been, I want to get fit. How fit can I get? 400 watt FTP, 420 watt FTP, 500 watts for 5 minutes. And I'd have all these goals. I want to get that KOM. I want to put 10 seconds into that KOM. I want to win this race. I want to win that race. So it was never like, oh, I'm training for nationals. So I always had all these irons in the fire, or whatever you call it. And I think that really helped me. What happens, and I see this a lot with comments on my channel, especially with cyclists, we are an anal bunch, including myself. And what we like to do are take things and complicate the crap out of them. And I know I've done that myself. What I have found when I am training the best and I'm doing the best, it's when I keep things simple. Working out, consistency, doing the workouts, sleeping well, eating well, all my off-bike recovery, stretching, core work, strength work, all that stuff, that is tied into this other big problem that I used to run into a lot. And it's the exact same kind of mindset. All I think about is doing it. I don't think, last year I had a big problem with, oh, am I gonna get my fitness back? I gotta do this. I gotta take a nap after every ride. Oh, am I, and I would just be so tense about everything that absolutely sent me downhill. The where I've always performed the best is with a positive, simple mindset. So it's positivity. Today I got my workout done. Today I had good meals, healthy meals. I'm gonna get some good sleep tonight. Good day done. Let's get to the next one. And I didn't focus on the results. Oh, what were my watts today? What was this? Oh, what was that? And I always, and like, if I get in the mindset of comparing what I'm doing now to another time, oh, but last year I did this watch. Oh, but last year I did that watch. Is it the same as this year? Oh, am I losing fitness? Am I gaining fitness? If I'm in that mindset, it's very bad. So the like I keep saying, the times that I've performed the best and achieved the most fitness is when I've kept it simple and didn't overcomplicate things, kept it positive, and just day in, day out, did the workouts, ate right, recovered right, did my off-bike recovery, stretching, core, strength, and I just was steady on that stuff. That's when I've had the best results. This video was a little bit off the cuff today, and it's because I wanted you to get to know me a little bit better and just kind of see my mindset and my journey into cycling. And I see a lot of comments, and I think people, when I see some comments, I think people don't really know who I am or like understand my experience or how long I've been doing this or my lifestyle. The future, I'm gonna be branching into some other things. This is one of the reasons I started YouTube, but I got some big ideas, some other things I wanna do. But that was the main purpose of this video, is to just kind of show you who I am and like, you know, my journey. And maybe some of this stuff could help you. And I really like it, like when people pull back the curtain and I can like understand them a bit better. So that's why I did this. So if you enjoyed the video, thank you. I love you guys. I'll see you on the next video. I'll see you soon. Bye.